All right, a little ground fishing 101 with Captain Glenn Crabtree on his 28-foot Grady White center console. I'm sure there's some certain name for it.
283 release.
There you go. We just hit the cod grounds. We're searching for some fish. We're not seeing too much on the screen yet, but as long as we don't see dogfish, I guess that's a good thing. I gotta go get my line set up here. Russell's already cutting bait. Here's the jig I'm choosing to use today. It's a little Shimano, actually a speed jig. I use it for tuna a lot, but I don't tuna fish anymore, so I'm using it for cod. Got a Dow Asaltus 2-speed reel, which is overkill for ground fish, but Glenn had one and I really liked the setup, so I bought one. Russell just picked up a 2-speed Avett, I believe. Ooh. Yes?
Yes, I did.
So he'll be fishing that. Little teasers that we run. This is our secret one right here for on Stellwagen. This is one I threw on last week to keep the dogfish. I figured I'd feed the dogfish this one if they wanted it, and I wouldn't lose a good teaser, but it turned out to be a really hot teaser last week, so we'll see what it does this week. It's kind of beat up. It's not held on by much, so I'm going to stick it through some rubber again. Hope it lasts a few fish. Sounds like the captain hasn't seen anything here, so we'll be moving until we find something. All right, we're on some fish. Nothing huge yet. A 3-small haddock. Glenn dropped a big fish, he says. A what? I'm just letting my line down here. I got a really light jig, so it takes a while to get down there. But once I do, I'll lock it up and I do what they call tend bottom and make sure that I'm always contacting bottom when I release my line back down. Oh, Glenn's on a nice fish now. That looks like a keeper. All right, I just hit bottom. See how my line's not coming out? I'm going to click that up. I'm going to lift my rod tip. Now it's not hitting bottom again, so I'll let a little more line out until I do hit bottom. And I'll continue doing that until I get a bite.
Coming a little rail rock.
These two guys are on. I'm still waiting for a bite. May have to go to a bigger jig. Glenn's got doubles. Looks like a keeper on the trailer. Nope, maybe not. Snagged him. Oh, there's a bite. I'm letting out, and I just had a bite on the let out. I could feel it. I missed him. Here comes Russ. Looks like, oh, there's a nice hit. That could be a keeper, Russ. That was a nice hit. Doesn't feel very big, but you know what? You gotta take the big with the small. At least they're not dogfish. Russell measuring up a nice 17 and a half inch fish.
Where are we putting them?
Here's Mark with a little shorty. And he swims away. I got another short.
I got two, so what?
One, I got two shorts.
Four, you got five so far?
That would be correct.
Okay, five for them. I just got two. Five. Mark, you got one?
I've got two. Two shorts. Oh, that's what I was going to get. My clips. Russell, you want to clip your fish? I'm wearing my ditty bag. I got some handy dandy clips for counting fish. I just gotta find them. Oh, they're not in this bag, they're in my other bag. Hang on. I got some line out here. Alright, I'm on bottom. I don't know if I trust that holder. Rest is on again. Totally unprepared here. Here we go. There's my clips. Got 15 on here. I clip one on every time I get a fish. Rash, you want your clips? Yeah. All right, here. Rash is back on again. It might be more weight. It might be the way to go here. We have to see if they're biting fairly quickly. Glenn is on. I might have got cleaned while I was getting my clips. Yeah, I got to go to a little heavier jig here, I think.
Yeah, all doubles. Doubles
looks like shorties, though. Another shorty for Glenn. Right species, the wrong size. Oh, and there I am, I'm on. Yeah, I'll definitely be upping my jig size once I pull this in. So we're gonna get my sea legs here. This is how I get handicapped. I get forced to the front of the boat by the captain. We have a little competition going today, who's going to get their limit first. So far, Russell is in the lead. This guy could be K for close. I don't like keeping the real small ones. Unless that's all we're catching, which right now that's all we're catching. So if he's 17, he'll keep. I don't think he's going to make it, though. Oh, just shy by about 3/8 of an inch. All right. Up the jig size. Here's the one I was using last week. This one worked really well. See how it does this week. So far, my hot teaser has not had a hit. Everything's been on the jig. My first fish was on the jig, and this one was on a piece of clam. See, this is another thing they leave. They leave me all this belly scraps because they don't want to use them. So I can still catch my limit on belly scraps. Not a problem for me. That's Glenn grunting over something. I think he's got a fish on. He dropped it. That's usually a rookie mistake. Rookies drop a lot of fish. It's only been out a few weeks now. Oh, there goes that belly meat. That's why they don't like to use it. Drops right off the hook sometimes. Well, like I say, hey, I'll take the scraps. Somebody's gonna use them. Glenn went oop, oop, oop. Oh, he didn't lose this one yet. So we're in the right species, wrong size at the moment. Glenn working that Penn Senator 113. See if we can see his fish coming up. And, oh yeah, they're so thick down there, you can snag them. They're not even biting. He's snagging them. Oh, look at that, lock and drop. Come on, this one's a keeper. As soon as I hit the bottom, I'm telling you, it's just jig. This jig is a sweetie. I'll be picking up a few more of those next time I head up towards Portsmouth, which should be soon. Why does my Royal feel like it's reeling screwed up here? I wonder if I missed an eye or something. I'll have to check that. Oh, look at that bad boy.
Woo!
Unfortunately, it's a cod. And these are endangered. Yeah, there's none of these around, folks. This is not get caught today. All over my sand eel. Open your mouth. Like to get my teaser unharmed and the bait if possible. Come on. Thank you. Been a pleasure doing business with you. Ah, he killed my teaser. And these aren't cheap, so we do what we can to make them work some more. Boy, as soon as I hit bottom, that fish was on. Okay, does it look like I am through all my eyes correctly? Yes, 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 yes. So, I don't know what the heck was going on there. Maybe I was wrapped on the tip or something. All right, back to the grind. Did you mark down my one keeper throwback cod? If we were 3 miles out, I could have kept that bad boy.
Yep.
And in August, I would have been able to keep them. I don't know why they pick August. They figure no one could catch a fish in August or something? I don't know. Less pressure? Maybe it's less pressure on them? I don't know. Here's bottom. Oh, I didn't have a fish. What the heck's going on here? I like that stop and pop.
Yeah.
This extra line out, it's not fun. Oh, we're off the fish.
Yeah.
Gotta tell the captain. Captain, we're off the fish! That's funny, what will happen, you'll see one guy hook up, and then the next guy, and then all three of us will get hooked up here. And about the same time, oh, Russ just had a bite, so they're there, they're coming. He's got the heaviest weight, so if they're coming from behind us, he'll hit them first. If they're coming from the other end, I think I'm still the lightest weight, or, no, actually Glenn and I are the same. Oh, there's one. There we go, that's a nice fish. This feels like a beauty. Oh, I guess they're making lie. Oh, Glenn's on. Here we go. That's the tail of mine hitting your line, Glenn. Don't worry about it. Another handicap. I got to come up over this high rail. Here comes my fish. Oh, another big cod. Well, not big, but decent sized cod. I would have kept him if this was August. And he was liking. All right, settle down, buddy. He was liking that teaser. There he goes. It's another endangered cod by Glenn. Glenn's got a cod over there. Russell. What do you got, Russ? Nothing?
I'm going to check my bait. What bait?
Oh, easy on the gel coat. Well, we keep getting these cod. We're probably going to have to move. Get away from them. That's what Nymph says we can do. I don't know. I find cod mixed in with haddock all the time.
Yeah, no. Yeah, right?
But what do I know? Maybe you can get away from them. I know the haddock like the mud. Looks like on this side, everybody's on that side of the edge, though. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I'm noticing that.
I'm wondering if we need to be that way. Or by now. Problem this time of year, you don't know who's tuna fishing, who's not. None of these guys are on anchor, so I'm guessing they're not tuna fishing, but... Here we go down. I'm not going to leave this on too much longer. You guys are probably getting bored already. Not too many hints. What's that?
Who's where? Down, you're down, what's up? Come on.
Could go to the head mount. Maybe it would be better than the chest mount here. I don't know. Got the fisheye view camera. The other one we have mounted on the back. We haven't started that bad boy up yet. Tide just started running in. We only need a good hour here, guys, to get our limit. I have yet to put a keeper in the box. What the hell, Cap'n? Huh? But I do enjoy catching any size fish. Russ is on, so you can expect the rest of us to be... Oh, did you drop him?
Yeah.
Oh, another rookie mistake back there. I haven't dropped a fish yet.
A little breezy around here today, though.
Huh?
A little breezier.
Yeah. Well, what's funny is it's coming from the north, too. I thought it was supposed to be northeast today. Glenn is hooked up. I got nothing.
Oh, there's a whale.
Oh, big whale right next to us. Well, not big, but... Any tail action? Nope. So it might have been a minke or a finback. Oh, there he is. He's just mulling at the surface. If the tail comes out of the water, it's a humpback. Hey, Glenn's got his first keeper haddock. That puts him up one on me. That's not good for me. I might have jinxed myself today with my trash talking all the way here. Use your clips.
Yeah, I know, I am.
Oh, there we go. See that? I wasn't on bottom. I let out a little extra line and boom, I'm on bottom. As soon as you get to the bottom, that's where they're at. Especially when the tide's running hard like this. They'll hang real tight to the bottom. Oh, I almost dropped them. I would have been calling myself for a rookie mistake here. Still got them. Russ is bringing in nothing. I got a lot of line out before I get that bite. Hopefully it's not another cod, and it's not. And hopefully it's a keeper, which will tie me with Glenn. That's my goal here. Well, my goal is to beat him, but this is definitely a keeper, no doubt in my mind. I do. And 20 and a half inches.
Woo-hoo!
On the board.
On the board. All right, I'm falling out the captain now.
You got, the bleeding knife? Come on.
Yeah.
All right, I gotta be careful. I've got my camera all bloody here. Just cut him, let him bleed. Oops, nice, who did that? These guys get the bucket back here. I get nothing up front. Hate them. All right, I'm shutting this off. I'll get back to you later.